Hallelujah. I listen to a renowned speaker. She's speaking for you guys this evening. Y'all, ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Miss Cece Echols. Come on, Miss Cece. Oh, I know Miss Cece 10 years ago. Hey.
Good evening, everyone. I bring you greetings from Decatur, Georgia, and we are so grateful to be here. I am here with Latoria Newman and Nynette Randall. These two ladies, they actually drove up 4.5 hours with me, but can we give God praise for them? Amen. And it's nothing like having a friendship. And I am so close to these ladies by the Spirit, because sometimes you can be close to your friends and your own relatives, amen. And I thank God for them, because they wanted to come and they wanted to support me, and I give God praise for that, amen. Well, I believe I have a word for the house. And we're going to have another prayer right quick, and I'm not sure how long it's going to be, but we're going to let the Lord have his way, amen. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, first of all, we thank you, Lord God, for this time of fellowship. We thank you, Lord God, for this occasion, Lord God. Father, we thank you, Lord God, for everybody that's here, Lord God. Father, I thank you, Lord God, that I have a prepared message, Lord God. But Father, I say you have your way in this place. Saturate this place, Lord God, with your atmosphere, Lord God. Father, we give you all the praise. We give you all the honor, Lord God. Father, you know the needs of everybody that's here, Lord God. And Father, I don't want to be where you are not. And I know you are here, Lord God. And Father, I just thank you, Lord God, for indwelling this place, Lord God, with your Spirit. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Let everybody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. I have been a part of a book club called, it's Latoria Newman's book club. And we've been studying a book called Finding Purpose Past Your Pain. And y'all, this book is so good because it allows you to search yourself. It's not for babies, but it's going to allow you to take a good look at who you are, and even in the midst of your mess, how you can come out of that mess. Amen? So today I want to talk briefly about, from the topic, Even This. Even this. The chapter that we were studying on was dealing with injustice. And the word injustice means unfair treatment. Amen? And a lot of times we're dealing with a lot of things that we feel is just not right. Can I get somebody to say amen?
Amen.
Because I'm going to need your help if y'all want it. Look, first of all, stretch forth your hands towards me. Don't be scared. And just believe that you're going to get what you need from me, amen, and from anybody else that's going to be speaking. Because everybody looks really good right now, and it's beautifully decorated, amen. But pull from me and ask God to give you what you need, amen. Otherwise, it's a waste of time. We're going to dance in a minute. The comedian is going to be very funny because I've heard her before. But right now, let's give God his attention. Let's give God some his undivided attention. Can we give God some praise? Amen. 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 Hallelujah. But as I was saying was, the word injustice means unfair treatment. Hallelujah. And a lot of times we go through things that's just not right. But in the book was talking about, who are we to define what is injustice? It's God that determines what is just and what is injustice, amen? When you talk about the book of Job, Job 1:6, Job was a perfect man before the Lord. He was upright. And the thing I liked about Job was because even though he had 7 sons, he had 3 daughters, he was very wealthy. And scripture says that there were times he would even make offerings before his kid, before God, on behalf of his kids in the event that they sinned. Is that right? Okay, that's what the word says now. So that lets me know that Job was an intercessor. He was a father, but he also worshipped. Amen? Want to give you a little brief history. Everybody knows the story of Job. Job actually was a rich man, as I said earlier. He had seven kids. He had 10 kids total, seven sons and three daughters. He had so many cattle, so many oxen, and back then, that was considered wealth. Amen? So there was a time where Satan comes and he said, you know, Jesus, God was like, where are you going, Satan? He's like, I'm going to and fro. I'm going to and fro. In other words, he's going back and forth. Back and forth. He says, have you spotted my servant Job? We all know that story. We all know the different things that Job went through. Amen. The thing that I was scratching my head was, Job, you was upright. But yet still, all this stuff came upon you. Scripture says in verse 16, while he was speaking, a messenger came and gave him some bad news. So it's just like I'm talking to this sister right here. And such and such and such and such. And such and such and such and such. I get tapped on the shoulder. Excuse me. What? My children, my son, my daughter get tapped on the shoulder again. What? So Job was going through some stuff. And we would think that that would be an injustice. Amen?
Amen.
Another person that I want to talk about is there was another man in the Bible that was blind. But before I get to that, there are two types of injustice. There's a self-inflicted injustice, and there's a God-inflicted injustice. The self-inflicted injustice is sin. S-I-N. Self-inflicted nonsense. So a lot of times when we go through things, we can't say, you know, oh, why you treat me so bad? Because there's a consequence when it's a self-inflicted injustice. Let the church say amen. Here we go in here. Amen. So I remember when I was a little girl, my grandmother, you know, back then, the older people would keep money two places, either in their bosom or either in a handkerchief. So my grandmother used to keep coins in a handkerchief. And I remember, as I think I was five, I went inside her handkerchief. And I saw a nipple. It was just a nipple. But talk about the injustice I got when I got home. Because that was a consequence that was attached to my disobedience. With Job, Job went through so many things. So when it's a man-made, self-inflicted consequence, there's going to be a consequence that you're going to have to reap. When it's God's injustice, then God will give you the grace to deal with it. Am I making sense?
Amen.
So y'all looking at the time of strength. That make sense?
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
There was another man in the Bible, John 9, 1 and 3. A man was blind at birth. And the first question that was asked was, who sinned? Did you sin? Did your parents sin?
No.
And then scripture said, neither, but that it would be that I might get the glory, says the Lord.
Amen.
So a lot of times when we're going through things, the first thing we need to ask ourselves is this self-inflicted nonsense where I'm having to reap a consequence? Or is this a God thing where he can be glorified even in this? Amen? Okay, so let's give this blind man a name. Let's call his first name, just because we're in 2018, let's call his name Stevie. And let's call his last name Wonder. Stevie Wonder was blind at birth. He had an eye issue, and it worsened in the incubator. And all these different things that he was able to accomplish, by the age of 13 years old, he had a number one hit song on the Billboard. He received 25 Grammys and a Lifetime Achievement Award. Now this is the thing that got me. He also rallied to make ML King a holiday. I totally forgot about that. But he was blind at birth. He couldn't see. And in my research, I think he also flew an airplane. How he did that?
It's love that you're running from.
gone away. With no future, my life is still blue. So day after day, I stay locked up in my room. But even you might sound strange, but I wish you would pray.
I'm Everybody should know this song, right?
Yeah, I know.
That's what I'm talking about.